Today, we can read Xochitl and the Flowers. The story is by Jorge Argueta and illustrated by Carl Angel. Here in this neighborhood, far from El Salvador, everyone knows us as the Flower Family because of our last name is Flores. They call my mommy Doña Servila Flores. That's Mrs. Flowers. And my puppy, Don Obdilo Flores, Mr. Flowers. And me, Xochitl, the Flores Flower Girl. When we lived in El Salvador, my grandfather, Ruben, cheerfully told me that Xochitl means flower in the Nahuatl language. A long, long time ago, he told me, long before the Spaniards even dreamed of coming to our land, our ancestors, Nahuatl Indians, just like you, lived here. We named you Xochitl in their honor. In the teeny San Francisco apartment where we live now with our Uncle Benjamin and Aunt Candelaria, I miss El Salvador. I miss the weekends when I sat in our garden with my mommy and papi arranging bouquets of flowers. Over there, our flowers made everybody happy. When Fidel married Rosa, we decked out the house like a garden. When Girlito, the shoemaker's dog, died, we made him a big, beautiful bouquet. And for Lala Osorio's 15th birthday, her family asked us to make 15 nosegays for her 15 friends. Here, days go by as slow as turtles. At night, I hear my mommy tell my papi about the flower shop she'd like to have in this country. My mommy works every day cleaning houses with Aunt Candelaria. On weekends, they take me along. My papi paints houses or works anywhere he can. And I draw flowers or write letters to grandparents, neighbors, and friends in El Salvador. In school, I can already say a few sentences in English. I practice them when I'm alone. I probably seem a little crazy when I ask myself, "How are you? My name is Xochitl. Do you like flowers?" One afternoon, my mommy brings home a pail full of lovely white roses and red roses, sunflowers, and freckle-faced stargazer lilies. "Xochitl, I'm going to sell flowers," she says. And I'm so happy when I see the blossoms that I bounce. "Can I help you?" I ask. "Of course, Xochitl," she smiles. Later that day, my mommy and I sell flowers on the street. She fills a small bucket with water and sprays of roses. It's light enough for me to carry. I feel like a butterfly. With the flowers and my mommy by my side, I have everything I need. In the flowers, I see my abuelitos, my neighbors, and everything we left behind in El Salvador. We go in and out of restaurants and stores asking, "Do you want flowers? We have roses, lilies, and sunflowers. Which would you like?" Every day we meet more and more neighbors, and they get to know us. In the coffee shop on the corner, we make friends with Mr. Awad, the Arab-American man with small eyes and a big smile. When Don Prudencio, the mariachi guitarist, sees us anywhere at all, he stops to talk. And Doña Ivania, the owner of El Treble, the restaurant with the glass door, lets us sell flowers to her customers. I like selling flowers, but when we get home late at night, my mommy and I have to soak our feet in the tub. That's how tired we are. One Saturday morning, while the three of us arrange flower bouquets, my papi tells us, "I've got a big surprise for you." "Tell me what it is," I beg. "What's this huge surprise?" my mommy asks. My papi opens his eyes wide and announces, "I found an apartment to rent that has a yard in the back. The yard is filled with garbage right now, but if the three of us work hard, we could turn it into a nursery and sell flowers and plants." "Flowers and plants?" my mommy and I both repeat, both of us at the same time. afterwards we're silent. There's so much going through our heads, we don't know what to say. No sooner said than done. The next Saturday, my papi borrows my Uncle Benjamin's blue truck, and the moving and cleaning begin. What a garbage heap, my mommy says. We make 3 trips to the dump. We throw out tires, pieces of iron, cardboard, glass, sand, part of a bed, and even a refrigerator door. Mr. Prudencio, who has come to help us out, selects the best pieces of wood. Mr. Awad paints them and makes tables. With the big and little stones that a neighbor gives us, we make paths. We bring in soil and arrange the little clay frogs. And Doña Ivania gives my mammy 2 parakeets as a present, and right away the yard begins to fill with music. My mammy is delighted. It's like magic, this forsaken place coming to life, she says happily. Now it's clean and pretty and ready for flowers and plants to come live here. Early Sunday morning, we buy yellow, white, and red roses. We buy bougainvilleas and blossoms as red as El Salvador evenings. Calla lilies with white, like white trumpets, sunflowers, small green chili plants, and dwarf lemon trees on which ants circle the world in just a few minutes. We buy aloe, magic green stars, and sweet, oh sweet, peppermint. My papi paints a sign on the white sheet. It says, Grand Opening Day Sale. Prices you can't refuse. Come and get them. Xochitl flowers and plants. Finally, everything is ready. Don Prudencio has brought his musician friends. They sing country songs, mommy's favorites. Balloons of different colors sway in the breeze along the flowers and plants. A plump and pretty neighbor makes a huge pot of sweet horchata drink for the customers who are about to arrive. Neighbors come in, and everything is going wonderfully when sudden, in the midst of all the celebration, a man appears tall and bearded, his skin the color of ashes. He has a piece of paper in his hand, and he shouts in an angry voice, What do you think you're doing here? What? This is a residential neighborhood. It's not a place for entertaining strangers. He shows us what he's carrying. It's a letter. First thing tomorrow morning, I'm letting the authorities know what you're up to. He's Don Roberto, the owner of our little lot, and he doesn't want us to set up our business. We are honest working people, my papi answers him. But Don Roberto is too angry to listen. He leaves. Just like that, we all have tears in our eyes. This isn't fair, Don Prudencio says. We won't allow this, my Aunt Candelaria adds. We'll fight it, Mr. Awad shouts in a little bit of Spanish he knows. The neighbors make a circle, putting their heads together as they whisper. Suddenly, one man says, Doña Candelaria should do the talking. Yes, yes, the neighbors shout. And Doña Ivania adds, and I'm going home to get something very special. My mammy and papi and I are so sad that we don't even notice when they all leave together. Hours later, while my mammy and my papi and I are slowly cleaning what's left of our lovely nursery, we hear voices coming closer. It's the neighbors. And with them is Don Roberto, the landlord, who has a green parakeet on his shoulder. It's nibbling on his ear. We went to Don Roberto's house, my Uncle Benjamin says. We pleaded with him as good neighbors. We explained that a nursery was better than a garbage heap. And I gave him a gift, a parakeet to soften his heart, Doña Ivania adds. The yard starts to fill with music once more. I told them you could stay here, Don Roberto says, just as long as you let me and my parakeet come to see the flowers. In my country, I had a bird just like this one, but it flew away. A smile blooms on his lips like a flower. From her apron, my mammy takes out a little red cloth bag. Here's a little bit of earth I brought from El Salvador, she tells me as she spreads it between the flowers and the plants. Now no one can say we don't belong here. And my mammy and I, we smile as we watch the snails go by, carrying their little homes on their backs. And that is the end of this story.